Arachnids get negative criticism in the animals of the world collectively, regularly portrayed as unpleasant, chilling, and in any event, startling. 6% of us are so fanatically terrified of our eight-legged companions, our dread has been named a fear, most of us endure them. Their picture isn't upgraded by their bushy legs, numerous eyes, and toxin trickling teeth. This is the reason they're a staple of baddie thrillers and Halloween decor, but there are creepy crawlies that are shockingly satisfying to the eye. While not many of us will probably buy stuffed similarities of these insects to nestle, it's difficult to contend their excellence. Hello everyone, welcome to Mr. Top 10 YouTube channel. This time we're talking about top 10 astonishingly beautiful spiders in the planet. Okay, let's start. Number 10. Sparklemuffin. Like most peacock bugs, Meredith jactatus does an intricate romance dance accentuated by leg kicks. Envision a rocket who's neglected to shave their legs. We'll see another peacock arachnid later. In 2014, wide point perspective on this dance, to the capacity to see movement. Shockingly for him, if Miss Sparklemuffin doesn't care for what she sees, she'll lead him. Just four of her eyes see forward, the rest shining a different light on having eyes in the back and side of your head. Those eyes can likewise see a far more noteworthy range of shadings than the human eye. Perhaps similarly as astounding as Sparklemuffin's footloose disposition is that his size doesn't coordinate his dauntlessness. Sparklemuffin estimates a simple 4 millimeters and could roost easily on your pinky's fingernail. Number 9. Brazilian Crab Spider. Epicodus heterogaster is an individual from the crab bug family, alleged on the grounds that their front legs are longer and curve forward rather than descending, giving them a crab appearance. They additionally can likewise crab walk sideways and in reverse. Crab creepy crawlies don't turn networks, yet stand by until bugs approach enough to ambush. Epicodus heterogaster does this two different ways. The more modest adolescent covers itself by roosting on blossoms that coordinate its shading, either white, yellow or purple. 3. It additionally has a stomach bulge that could be confused with bloom petals. Indeed, even its moderate, jerky developments look more like foliage influencing in the breeze, and grown-up Epicodus heterogaster can likewise draw bugs with a body shading that mirrors UV light. Researchers found this when they applied sunscreen to the rear of a female and watched creepy crawlies overlook it. They don't know why UV intelligent light pulls in pollinating bugs, however it's conceivable the light mirrors a bloom's UV shading examples or characteristic splendid spots. Number 8. Metallic Blue Tarantula. First characterized in 1899 as Poecilotheria metallica after it was found in the Gudi train yard in South Focal, India, this tarantula for all intents and purposes vanished for a very long time. Rediscovered in 2001 of every a little 100 kilometers forested zone in India's Kadapa and Chittor regions of Andhra Pradesh, it immediately turned into a valued pet for tarantula aficionados. Which is both heartbreaking and blessed for this delightful bug. Andhra Pradesh's woodland is rapidly debasing because of logging and human infringement, putting the Gudi sapphire on the basically imperiled species list. What was more regrettable, in the years after it was rediscovered, poachers cut these tarantulas to sell. It is presently illicit to remove Gudi sapphires from their common environment, however it is legitimate to buy trained bugs and breed them. Their prevalence in Europe and the US may give the species new hope in the wild. Gudi sapphires fabricate channel networks in the openings of trees, and hold on to snare any creepy crawly that draws close. They at that point nibble their prey with their venomous 3/4-inch teeth. Which implies just experienced tarantula lovers should accept a Gudi sapphire as pets. They're forceful and quick. While their toxin isn't ordinarily destructive to people, their nibble is excruciating, and will give a human migraines and expanded pulses for as long as 7 days. Number 7. Mirror Spider. Another Australian local, Thuatesia nigra nodosa lives in Queensland's rainforests. Like the greater part of the different individuals from the family Thuatesia, it has been given the monikers sequin spider or mirror spider, a reference to its disco ball-like butt. Its trunk is loaded up with particular cells called guanocytes, a crystallized adaptation of a stomach-related byproduct, guanine, that the arachnid would typically crap out. The guanine mirrors light, causing it to seem silver, similar to a mirror, and the consolidated cells structure such a crap mosaic. This glittery keister is particularly useful when covering up among the downpour flickered foliage of a rainforest. The mirror spider has one more guard instrument. If it's upset or should rapidly drop from its web, it can promptly stow away the guanosite cells, changing its external appearance to a drabber tone, similar to the sloppy ground. How it does this isn't surely known, however it's trusted it contracts muscles that cover the guanosites. So, butt grasps. Number 6. Elegant Golden Jumping Spider. We've thought about the delightful chrysalolata for over 130 years, however it is so uncommon, thus small, a simple few millimeters in size, little is thought about it. We don't have the foggiest idea whether its delightful glowing shading is for cover or grabbing a mate's attention. We're not even entirely certain what a female of this species looks like. What we do know is that chrysalolata is an individual from the bouncing creepy crawly family, and the couple of recordings of it show that this little person is a list long jumper. There are in excess of 5,000 types of hopping creepy crawlies, and make up around 13% of all insect species. Despite the fact that they have no leg muscles, they can hop multiple times their own length utilizing pressure-driven movement. Their shaggy legs additionally give them footing in basically any territory including glass that landscape is normally in the wildernesses of China, Burma and Vietnam. Number 5. 8 Spotted Crab Spider. Among the biggest crab creepy crawlies on the planet, Platythomyces octomaculatus can be 7.6 centimeters in size. In spite of this, they are moderately slippery in the wilds of Southeast Asia extending from India to Burma to Singapore. If the name 8 Spotted is confounding in the wake of tallying the arachnid spots, you're in good company. At the point when the German arachnologist Karl Koch called the species octomaculatus back in 1845, nobody appears to realize which spots he was tallying. His drawings of the species shows 4 sets of stomach spots, not the 3 sets in addition to a lengthened bar we see today. What makes it much all the more confounding, the quantity of spots on this present insect's dorsal midsection changes as it develops. Hatchlings have just 2, and, as it ages, obtains more spots on the highest point of its midsection. However, one major one under. It additionally grows 6 on the forward piece of the bug known as the carapace, including the supposed panda spots around its eyes. What's more terrible? The size of the spots on the grown-up female subsequent to laying eggs changes altogether. The disarray has prompted misidentification of numerous different species with comparative spots. Number 4. Triangular Spider. We've for quite some time known for quite a while that horseshoe crabs were not crabs by any stretch of the imagination, yet it wasn't until 2019 that researchers parsed its DNA to find it really was a removed cousin to bugs and scorpions. If we analyze the outsides of creepy crawlies and crabs, it is not difficult to accept they were connected. They are the 2 arthropods, with their skeletons outwardly and both have jointed legs. Also, Archis lancerius, an individual from the creepy crawly crab family, has the shading and midsection shaped like its shellfish namesake. Indeed, even its legs are crab-like. That is until you check the legs. 8-legged creature have 8, shellfish at least 10 also. When we take a gander at the innards of crabs and arachnids, we can unmistakably see they are not actually related at all. Like horseshoe crabs, 3-sided insects resist order. Since it was first portrayed in 1837, Archis lancerius has been set in a few unique families and the discussion is as yet seething. They are normal in the hotter environs of Australia and New Zealand, and come in one or the other red, yellow, orange, earthy-colored, highly contrasting hues. They are snare trackers, utilizing webbing as well-being lines instead of in catching prey. Number 3. Longhorned Spider. Of the 35,000 types of bugs, half of them structure networks to get prey. Maybe the most conspicuous networks are the spiral framework ones, comprised of concentric circles and held together by spokes. The majority of these manifestations, ordinarily utilized in Halloween adornments, are crafted by the sphere weaver family. The expression sphere can be befuddling, as it begins from the early English word for a two-dimensional hover, as opposed to the advanced three-dimensional circle. With an excess of 3,000 species, the Araneidae family is the 3rd biggest among creepy crawlies, and the most assorted in size and appearance. As if to make the statement, the female Macrocantha arcuidis sports an amazing pair of reception apparatus-like horns on its midsection. In any case, those horns are not intended to get a few tunes, yet, It's accepted to make her additionally scary to predators. Those midsections can either be red, white, dark or yellow, and the females are frequently about a centimeter in size. The male is generally a tenth of that in size, which makes him nibble size for the female after coitus. Macrocantha arcuata is one more native of the wildernesses of Southeast Asia, yet, due to incidental presentations, can likewise now be found in Southeast United States. Number 2. Cat-faced spider, another circle weaver, Araneus gemmaites has been named the cat-confronted bug on account of the pair of horns on its midsection that resemble a kitty's ears. Back to the horns are eye-like dimples with striations on either side like a tabby's striped cheeks. To finish the picture, the mid-region is shrouded in little fine hairs. Araneus gemmaites comes in different shadings going from a light yellow to a dim brown. The feline-confronted arachnid is genuinely normal in the western United States, their home extending from Alaska to California and as far east as Colorado. Both genders have bulbous butts, yet the females get significantly more bulbous after she mates with her lover. Before the colder time of year ice, mom is dead, leaving a generous egg sac crammed with exacting kids. In the spring, the eight-legged angels nibble on one another before they raise luxurious strings to get a breeze and convey them somewhere else. The toxin of Araneus gemmaites isn't risky to a human, nor can its teeth penetrate the skin. However, those teeth can give the rear of your hand an extreme squeeze. Number 1. Redback spider. The redback spider, at times called the Australian black widow, is regularly confused with a black widow because of the comparable shading and red imprint found on the backs of females. They are profoundly venomous with a mixed drink of various kinds of neurotoxins that convey an astoundingly high measure of torment in humans. Fortunately, they don't regularly hit with full venomization, liking to keep down a portion of their valuable toxin for prey creatures. On the off chance that a redback spider were to convey its full burden in a chomp, it would almost certainly bring about death. That being stated, there have been no realized passings credited to these creepy crawlies since the innovation of its antidote in 1956. Prior to that time, a nibble could bring about death, which would almost certainly be a similar today were it impractical to get the antidote as expected. The risky side effects from a chomp incorporate queasiness, unreasonable perspiring close to nibble, muscle shortcoming, and spewing. These insects aren't especially modest, and they will strike an individual on the off chance that they feel undermined, which is what befallen one appalling Australian man who experienced one while sitting on a latrine.
Thank you guys so much watching this video. See you in next episode.